In this lecture, we'll study about generating function. Come to the definition. For a numeric function a0, a1, a2, dot dot up to ar, and so on, we define an infinite series. So out of this numeric function, we'll define an infinite series where we have introduced a variable z. So this is a0 plus a1z plus a2z square, and so on. Okay, so this infinite series is called the generating function of the numeric function a. Okay, so see here, this is actually a0 into z to the power 0, a1 into z to the power 1, a2 into z to the power 2, so on up to ar into z to the power r plus, and so on. So this infinite series where we have introduced a variable z is called as the generating function of the numeric function a. Okay, so for a numeric function a, we shall use the corresponding uppercase letter and write az to denote the generating function of a. So let's suppose a is a numeric function okay so corresponding to this numeric function a, we'll denote the generic function of a as uppercase of a, that is az. Similarly, if we have a numeric function b, then we'll denote the generic function corresponding to this numeric function as uppercase of b, that is bz. Okay, the coefficient of z to the power r is the value of the numeric function at r. Okay, so this coefficient of z to the power r, that is this, is the value of the numeric function a at r. In other words, we can say the coefficient of z to the power 2 is the value of the numeric function at 2. Okay, so here these are the value of the numeric function. The coefficient of all the z in this particular infinite series are the value of the numeric function. Okay, given a numeric function, we can obtain its generating function, and conversely, it means if we have given a numeric function, then we can find its corresponding generic function, and vice versa. It means if a generic function is given, then we can find the numeric function. Okay, so for example, the generating function of the numeric function, so this is a numeric function, so we can find out the generic function of this. So this generic function is similar to this particular infinite series. Okay, so here let's suppose this numeric function is nothing but d is equal to, you can write 3 to the power 0, 3 to the power 1, 3 to the power 2, 3 to the power r, and so on. Okay, so this numeric function can be written down in the form of generic function, that is dz is equal to 3 to the power 0, z to the power 0, plus 3 to the power 1, z to the power 1 plus, okay, 3 to the power 2, z to the power 2 plus 3 to the power r, z to the power r plus, and so on. Okay, so this particular generic function is similar to this. Okay, so is equal to 3 to the power 0, z to the power 0 is nothing but 1. Plus this is 3z plus 3z square plus, and so on, we have 3z to the power r, and so on. Okay, so this can be written in this form. So 3 to the power 0 is 1, 3z is 3z, 3 square z square is 3z whole to the power 2, and so on. Okay, and we know that we have a formula for an infinite series. If 1 divided by 1 minus x is equal to 1 plus x square plus x cube, and so on. So this particular generic function dz is in the form of this infinite series. So it can be written as dz can be written as 1 divided by 1 minus, here x is 3z. See here, 1 is 1 here, 3z is x, 3z square, that is x square. So in place of x you can write 3z. Okay, so the above infinite series can be written in closed form as this. So the infinite series, which is the generating function of this corresponding numeric function, can be written in the closed form as this. Okay, let a be a numeric function and alpha be a real number, then corresponding to b is equal to alpha a, we have generating function bz is equal to alpha into generating function az. Okay, so here we have two numeric function a and b, small a and small b. Okay, so, and if let's suppose alpha be a real number, and if we can write it down, b is equal to numeric function b is equal to alpha a, then we can also write it down in the form of generating function as bz is equal to alpha into az. Okay, so take an example. Find the generating function of the numeric function ar is equal to 7 into 3 to the power r, where r is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so here we have ar is equal to 7 into 3 to the power r. Okay, r greater than equal to 0. Okay, so write it down, this numeric function in the form of list. Okay, so put the value of r from 0, starting from 0, 1, 2 and so on. So this will be 7 into 3 to the power 0, 7 into 3 to the power 1, 7 into 3 to the power 2, 7 into 3 to the power r, and so on. Okay, so this ar can be written as 7 into 3 to the power 0 is 7, comma 7 into 3, 7 into 3 square, up to 7 into 3 to the power r, and so on. Okay, so now we'll write down the corresponding generating function of this numeric function. So let us write down az is equal to 7 z to the power 0 plus 7 into 3 into z to the power 1 plus 7 into 3 square into z square plus total up to 7 into 3 to the power r into z to the power r, and so on. Okay, so here let us take 7 as the common. So this z to the power 0 is 1 plus 7 we have taken as common here. So this is 3z plus 3z whole square plus up to 3z to the power r plus, and so on. Okay, so okay, now you can write it down, 7 into, so this is an infinite series which is equivalent to 1 plus x square plus and so on. So it can be written as 1 divided by 1 minus 3z. Okay, so here we can write it down, this is equal to 1 plus x square and so on. Okay, so you can write down 7 divided by 1 minus 3z. So this is the generic function corresponding to the numeric function ar equal to 7 into 3 to the power r. So this is the answer, we got it. Okay, come to another example. Find the generic function of the numeric function ar is equal to 3 to the power r plus 2, where r is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so similarly we will do this one. Ar is equal to 3. Okay, so here r greater than or equal to 0. So first of all, write it down, this numeric function in the form of list. Ar is equal to, okay, so first of all let us slightly solve this one. So this one is 3 to the power 0, 3 to the power r into 3 square. Okay, so this equal to 9 into 3 square is 9 into 3 to the power r. Okay, so now it is similar to the previous problem where we had 7 into something to the power r. Okay, so now it can be easily done as az is equal to 9 divided by 1 minus 3z. Okay, so this is the corresponding generic function of the numeric function. Okay, so this is the answer, we have got it, and that is similar to this answer. Okay.